Good morning to all. First of all, I would like to thank all the organizers of this program to have part of inviting me. I am indeed grateful to you, sirs and madam, who are involved in organizing this program. My special thanks are also due to Sri Patel, Professor Patel, in fact, for taking the lead in this. Sir, as you all are aware, I am an outsider. In the sense, I am not a library science man, but I am a political scientist. But when you invited me, I got curious and started working on this and took some help, of course. But one thing that I felt I should share with you is that it is not only that I am feeling that I am an outsider, but sometimes I feel today the librarians in most of the government colleges and private colleges are also feeling that they are outsiders, because more than being a librarian, they are also doing a lot of office work. That's what I see. I don't know whether you agree with this, but in today's world where internet gurus have come, and social media coupled with constant flow of information in the society, there seems to be a kind of a diminishing role that is looked upon for the librarians. People feel that when I have an internet, why would I go to the library? However, I see it differently. To me, your role and responsibility today is doubled. Instead of you people engaging in some office work in the colleges because you don't have many people visiting the library, or the students sitting in the library and reading or asking for borrowing books, I believe you have an increased responsibility. Let me try to put it in a different way. Now look at this. In this age of internet, I feel we need you to guide us how to search the needed information in the right way without strain. Because most of the time when we get onto the internet, we will be straying because we don't know where exactly to locate the information that is required. Now similarly, in this age of Google Masters, we need you to show us the way out of plagiarism. We need your guidance for honest reading and writing and not copy-paste. Similarly, in this era of overflowing information, we need your advice about the right information and the copyright knowledge so that we don't simply take things from the books or photocopy the books that are available in the library for my reading. Now in the age of social media, again, we need your guidance to teach us how responsibly and usefully can we utilize these services. Lastly, in this flood of technology, again, we need your guidance to appreciate the useful employment of technology in enhancing our skills in teaching, learning, and research. Therefore, my dear friends, please, I say please, give up your other interest in working in the offices and get back to the libraries. Because I want you to start a movement. Let's get back to the books. Let's get back to the libraries. This should be the kind of a movement that you should be coming up so that we can start going back to the original books, reading them, and writing originally. Friends, let us understand some of the basic things. You know, and I am learning now, that the basic DNA of librarianship never changes. It's ever dynamic and it is never constant. Ladies and gentlemen, you know the philosophy of librarianship. This is based on 5 laws of library science as propounded by the father of library science in India, Sri Dr. S. R. Ranganathan ji. Now this includes 5 laws of library science. Today, to me, I feel every one of these things seems to be challenged. Now the first law says, books are for use. Immediately comes to my mind, for whose use? How many people are getting into the library? When the reading habit is slowly dying, people are not visiting the libraries. Everybody is doing cut and paste. Who is using these books? Now, second thing is, every reader, his or her book. Is this true? I don't know whether this should be changed. You'll have to guide me in this. The third important point is, every book, its reader. Is this a fact anymore? That's my question. Now the fourth one is, save the time of the reader with the gadgets of all kinds. Is this needed? Last but not the least is, a library is a growing organism. Is this any truer in its original sense? Because today, if you look at the dwindling budgets to the universities, departments, there's hardly any book that we are recommending to the libraries. Most of the books which are originally written are extremely costly, and therefore what are we doing? We are trying to go in for the bazaar moves. Are we not reducing the standards of the libraries? Now why did I say that there are challenges? Listen to me. Although we tend to believe that these are the guiding factors, why is it that nobody wants to review it or even have a debate over it? Ranganathan ji did it way back. But today the context has changed. The readers have changed. The time has changed. So in this time, this silent acceptance without critical inputs and loss of innovation to keep the ideas of the father of library science alive and relevant has to have some kind of a innovation. We need to reinterpret these things. If that is not done, probably I see librarianship being at the crossroads. Therefore, it is time that we look at the changing times and redesign our professions rather than crying over the spilled milk. Current trends and technologies that are influencing librarianship today are enormously intellectual and skill oriented. Let us look at few of them. The first one is the ubiquitous computing, or the cloud computing as they call. Second one is the artificial intelligence. Internet of things, open access, open science, web 4.0, the emotional web as they call. All these things are highly technical, both in matters of knowledge and skills. Librarians who are surviving today, in order to remain in the mainstream, in my opinion, must focus on developing these skills. And their application from time to time must be learned by them. Which means that at this point of time, the technologies and the trends must be the focus, along with the responsibility of making this profession attractive. Please remember, I want you to go back and ask your managements and the governments to spend more on the technologies that are required for the libraries, otherwise it becomes completely meaningless. Now, I want you to ask them to spend time and understand the changing nature of the libraries. Tell your students about the future that is wedded to these technologies. Make your students understand that the libraries are welcoming them. But what I see on the contrary is, the libraries today look like dens. It frightens with darkness and wet smells. Why is it? Excepting that you try to reorder the books, I don't see bright lights, interactive, you know, sessions, and you are not even inviting authors so that they can discuss within the library the new books that they have written. You need to change. You need to develop the feeling that you are the leader for the future. You must make others believe that you are their future. Compared to yesteryears, your importance is more felt these days. Without our new technologies, and technologies like cloud computing, which offers immense possibilities to libraries, service, and service delivery, I don't think we are looking towards the future. From the delivery of computing services, including servers, storage, databases, networking, software, analytics, and intelligence over the internet, the cloud as they call, to offer faster innovations, flexible resources, and economies of scale, I think you will not be the librarians for the 21st century. I always believe that you are the miracle makers of tomorrow. Because you are the miracle makers of tomorrow, you will have to see that your institutions gear up to the next century. While institutions can afford setting up independent infrastructure, cloud computing services are increasingly being used by libraries and information centers. My dear friends, I want you to appraise the governments of the day that they need to invest in future libraries. Artificial intelligence is coming in a big way, particularly natural language processing, machine language. They've already made their impact on the libraries. The use of artificial intelligence for providing chatbot-based reference services is a classic example of application of AI in library services. Machine learning, sound and image processing technologies are already being used to analyze digital collections, to identify objects, entities, metadata, and provide non-textual search and discovery. What else do you need? You have the technology at hand. You will have to get up, and you will have to motivate your students, your colleagues in your departments, in your college, in your universities, so that they know that the libraries of today is not the libraries of yesteryears, where you will have to go and sit, do references for hours of, you know, in the library. That is not necessary. Data visualization tools offer real-time viewing of research productivity and impact data. Why? I think it's a wonderful thing that's happening. Librarians should take lead in getting these things and getting the training so that they can educate the academic, research, and professional communities in making the best use of data visualization tools to boost research visibility and impact. Sirs, please remember, I'm telling you, please remember, without you and your support, academics are nothing. Whatever we try to do, whatever thinking we may have, whatever critical input we may have, whatever interpretations we may have, but if these tools can support our thoughts and ideas, I think we can make miracles, we can change the society to such an extent that we are going to bring laurels to your library science as a profession. Internet of Things is an area with an abundant opportunities for libraries. As you may be aware, IoT deals with connecting physical objects, even commonly used objects such as water heaters, to the internet, thereby bringing seamless connectivity and control. Even RFID sounds like an application of IoT. RFID has been used very effectively by certain libraries. With the application of IoT, a new set of services including patron data based book recommendations system can also be brought about. Location based services could be helped. Better appliance management becomes possible. We can also educate a large section of youngsters to understand these things and become professionals in their own way. In fact, in educating all these things, I had to get back to my good friend, a young friend from Tumkur University, Dr. Rupesh Kumar, because I consulted him before I wrote this speech and requested him to give me those inputs. Now, emergence of open access and open science is a boon to libraries and information centers. Open access to scholarly literature offers solution to cut down on the exorbitant subscription cost of scholarly literature imposed by publishers. Gradual drifting of scientific community towards open science is sure to change the service landscape of libraries. Web 4.0, the future avatar of the web, which proposes a symbiotic relationship between humans and machines, may find a great deal of use in libraries. The intervention of librarians between the systems and the users may be maximized with the use of Web 4.0 technologies. Research data management is another area which will be a key skill expected in current and future generation of library professionals. If you don't change, the future will suffer. Please remember this. Implementation of research data management systems will augment research impact assessment, which today is an important criterion in any institutional ranking system. Librarians in this direction have a significant role to play. The need of the hour, my dear friends and librarians, is to remain relevant in the present context when diversification is taking place and our role playing must also diversify. We must learn to transcend the boundaries of conventional librarianship. We thought originally librarianship was just a job performed within the boundaries of four walls of the library. But today, librarians must transform themselves from document lenders to information facilitators, thereby making libraries facilitation centers. Trends such as makerspaces and 3D printing are impacting libraries, making them ideal spaces for collaboration learning. Librarians must exploit the benefits of such trends in the interest of designing and delivering attractive services, thereby ensuring user engagement. I am sure some of you will one day become vice chancellors of universities, and I want you to lead the universities to the next centuries. In my own little understanding, and the support that I received from a young scholar, Dr. Rupesh Kumar, who helped me to put things and shaping this valedictory address with meaningful contents, for which of course I acknowledge his help with sincerity. You know, this is an age where you need to cite the help that you take. You need to acknowledge the help that you take. I couldn't have done this on my own, because being an outsider, I had to learn, I had to read, I had to understand. I did not want to be somebody who comes and delivers a lecture which is meaningless. When I took this help, he really gave me an insight into how a librarian's life can change the academics, the world of academics, the universities, the institutions. So what I believe today is the need of the hour, and that need of the hour is we need librarians for the 21st century. We need librarians of the 21st century. You are not only having the responsibility to be the change you want to bring in, but you have the responsibility to change the younger generations who are drifting away from schools, colleges, universities and books, and also they are drifting away from the very habit of reading and writing. Even in the universities these days, there are challenges with stress on vernacular language as against English language. And there is a galore of confusion prevailing about publishing in impact factor journals, Scopus, etc. These things have left the younger scholars who have no idea about these things completely disarmed, without pen and paper. There is absolutely no input for them about how to go about in these challenging times. It is here that the academic standards are falling and the librarians have a responsibility, because if you help these academics, they can go with their heads held high. My request to all of you, therefore, now I am saying this as a request because you have invited me to speak to you, and it is my feeling that I have to share this with you. It is my request, my dear friends, therefore, please shed your inferiority, and you are the leaders. Believe me, you are the leaders. Please, you help us, guide us, and take the academicians to Golan Heights, because we are today competing amongst ourselves and around the world. I look forward to working with you, and I also thank Dr. Rupesh Kumar for his wonderful inputs and support. Thank you again for your patient hearing. Good day to all of you. Thank you, Dr. Patil sir, for inviting me and giving me this opportunity. I hope I have made some sense. Thank you.